Welcome back. A collaborative effort has resulted in the release of hundreds of fish into an area where they're needed.
And the best part is that they'll all be protected. Kirk Matthews has more in tonight's Be Green 2.
Nearly 2,000 Moi Fingerlings were released in Pico Lagoon, a part of Mauna Loa Bay, earlier this month.
They're primarily a near-shore reef-type fish. They like areas where there's some wave action, you know, some foam and splashing around and stuff. So, yeah, they're not a pelagic-type, open ocean-type fish. They're more of your near-shore-type, reef-type fish.
The effort was truly a cooperative one. The fingerlings were raised by the Oceanic Institute, and the Pico Lagoon comes under the care of the DLNR and the Department of Fish and Wildlife. Why this particular venue?
It's a real special place right there. There's a lot going on in that Pico Lagoon, Pico Reef. That was a really good feeling to see those moili'i be released in the Pico Lagoon area. Community very appreciative. You know, Pico is a very special area. There's a lot of good environmental things going on in that area.
Go swim!
Thanks in large part to the efforts of Malama Mauna Lua.
We do see some changes. Of course, these things don't happen overnight, but since, you know, we were able to remove that 27-plus acres of invasive algae, and the community is still going out there about once a month and removing algae.
Monitors will check on the development of the moi as time goes by.
I think that's one of the reasons why we really wanted to go with the Pico Lagoon area. It's a wildlife sanctuary, so you can't, it's not readily accessible to the public. You do need permit from DLNR to go through there.
And after all this hard work, what is the likely future of Pico Lagoon and Mauna Loa Bay?
The consensus is optimism because we see a little bit more variety coming in there of the different types of native limus. There's still a lot of invasive algae out there, so there's still a lot of work to do, but also the seagrass is very encouraging too.
Kirk Matthews, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.